الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، فتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على محمد وعلى آل محمد، كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن الصحابة أجمعين، وعن التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Indeed, all praises to Allah. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His forgiveness, we seek His assistance, and we seek His guidance. Whoever is guided by Allah, indeed he is guided. And whoever is left astray, for him you will find no guide and no supporter. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah, the one and only. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His final prophet and messenger. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon Prophet Muhammad and upon his family and upon his companions and upon those who followed them and those who follow them till the day of judgment. Allahumma ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. O you who believe, attain taqwa. Be aware of Allah as is worthy of Him, and die not except in a state of Islam. My dear brothers and sisters, we are in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. And this month is the third month in the Hijri calendar, the calendar that the Muslims chose for themselves and continue to follow. And in the minds of many of us, it is the month most closely associated with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some very significant events relating to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam happened in this month. He passed away in this month. He arrived in Medina when, after making his hijrah, in this month. And many people believe that he was also born in this month. There's no historical evidence to back up his birth. We don't know for sure. What we know from the ahadith is that he was born in the year of the elephant. The Arabs at the time did not keep accurate track of dates. So we don't know for sure when he was believed. But like I said, many people believe he was born in Rabi' al-Awwal. Some even specify it the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal. In many Muslim majority countries, that day is even a national holiday. The fact is, the Prophet ﷺ did not celebrate his birthday during his lifetime. The Sahaba did not celebrate his birthday after him. This whole idea of Mulid and these celebrations developed hundreds of years later. So there's no religious significance for the day that the Prophet ﷺ was born. There's no special ibadah, there's no special thing that we need to do. However, I'm sure all of you have been bombarded in the last week or two with people talking about Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, sending their peace and blessings upon him as is worthy of him, and mentioning him profusely. So I wanted to take this opportunity to do the same, but hopefully to be able to get some lessons for us from his life and from his character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. Allah has favored the believers. Allah here uses in Arabic the word manna. And usually al-man is not a good thing. In another ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the charity that we give, Allah says, وَلَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. Do not ruin your sadaqah, your charity, by reminding the person you gave the charity to about your favors upon them. That ruins it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like nothing else and nobody else. And He has the right to do whatever He wishes. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us of His favor upon us by sending, by selecting, by choosing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be His messenger to us. Indeed, it is a great favor. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as is His, I don't want to use the word style, but as it is throughout the Quran, whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and praises Prophet Muhammad, it's not because of his looks or his lineage or things like that. It's because of things that he did, actions, character, things that are examples for us to follow. And in this ayah, it's no different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us it is a favor from Him that He chose from among us a messenger. And again here, it's very important that Allah says He's one of us. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not a deity. He's a human being. He is the best human being. He's the example for us to follow, but he is a human being. Whatever he has is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who created us. Allah is the one who gives. Allah is the one who takes. Allah is the one who gives life and death. Not Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he is the best human being. And Allah is telling us it is a favor from him that he sent him to us to do what? يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ. To remind us, to recite to us the ayat of the Qur'an. We would not have the Qur'an today, or the Qur'an that we have today came to us through the revelation that came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that is his first job, to relay those ayat. And he did that. We have this Qur'an today with the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he promised. يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. This is the second thing why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to us. To elevate us, to purify us, to make us better people. الزَّكَاةَ زَكَّ الشَّيْءِ is to take out any impurities in it and make it as pure as you can do. So think if you have gold that is mixed with other things and you put some heat on it so that you can separate the real gold from the other things, that's what zakah is. You're pure. The Prophet ﷺ, his job is to purify us, to put us on that path that gets us closer to the Prophet, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And third, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, to teach us the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the wisdom, how to behave, how to react, how to use our intellect in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to use them. And then the ayah concludes, وَإِن كَانُوا مِن قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Prior to the sending of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we were for sure in manifest ignorance, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it. And even today, if we choose to ignore what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us, then we are for sure in manifest ignorance. And as I said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever He praises the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, the focus is on his character. As Allah says in another ayah, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Indeed, O Prophet Muhammad, you are of the highest character. And the Prophet ﷺ himself summarized his mission by saying, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was only sent to perfect, to complete, to preach, to communicate the highest of morals. That's the summary of why he was sent for us. And so today I'm going to focus on just one of those characteristics, one of those attributes, one of those khuluqs, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ. It is with the mercy of Allah that He has planted in you, O Muhammad, that you have been lenient with them. One of the greatest attributes of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his ability to deal with people in the most lenient and merciful way and still get results from them. Oftentimes we think of leniency and mercy as weakness, that we don't have the power to do something. But in this case, and it's always the case, should be the case, that mercy, when used properly, and leniency in its right proportion, is the best way. And that's how you get results from people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِدْتُمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. There has certainly come to you a messenger from among yourselves. He grieves greatly when you suffer. This is a great quality of the Prophet ﷺ. When he sees people suffering, when he sees people going on the right path, it bothers him. He feels for us. He is concerned over you, and to the believers, he is kind and merciful. The Prophet ﷺ also talked about this attribute of him by saying, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَحْمَةٌ مُهْدَىٰ. O people, I am but a mercy that had been given to you as a gift. In one hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ described his mission. And he gave an example. He said, مَثَلِي كَمَثَلِ رَجُلٍ اسْتَوْقَدَ نَارًا فَلَمَّا أَضَاءَتْ مَا حَوْلَهَا جَعَلَ الْفِرَاشُ وَهَذِهِ الدَّوَابُ الَّتِي فِي النَّارِ يَقَعْنَ فِيهَا وَجَعَلَ يَحْجُزُهُنَّ وَيَغْلِبْنَهُ فَيَتَقَحَّمْنَ فِيهَا قَالَ فَذَلِكُمْ مَثَلِي وَمَثَلُكُمْ أَنَا آخُذُ بِحِجَزِكُمْ عَنِ النَّارِ هَلُمَّ عَنِ النَّارِ فَتَغْلُبُونِي تَقَحَّمُونَ فِيهَا. He said, my example and your example is like the example of a man who lit a fire at night. And because of that fire, the bugs and the animals started running towards the fire, to the extent that they were throwing themselves inside the fire and they would burn. And so the man is standing and trying to push away these bugs and these animals to protect them from the harm of the fire, but they would overpower him and go around him and still throw themselves in the fire. He says, that is my example and your example. I'm standing and saying, stay away from the hellfire, and you go around me and you insist on throwing yourself inside the hellfire. So anything that he does, anything that he says, anything that he teaches us, it's for our own protection, to take us away from the danger that he sees clearly and we may not see it ourselves. The Prophet ﷺ, as we know, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another ayah, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you except to mercy to all the worlds, to all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just human beings, but all the creations of Allah. And we have several examples of that. But suffice it to mention a couple where the Prophet ﷺ once was asked There was a problem of stray dogs in Medina, and the Sahaba asked him for permission to kill these stray dogs. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Lawla anna al-kilab ummatun min al-umam akrahu an ufniha la amartu bi qatliha." Had it not been that the dogs are a nation of nations, and I'd hate to exterminate them, otherwise I would have given you permission. So he's saying they have the same rights to life as you do, and we have no right to kill them for no reason. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirms this meaning by saying, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا طَائِرٍ يَطِيرُ بِجَنَاحَيْهِ إِلَّا أُمَمٌ أَمْثَالُكُمْ مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. There is no animal that walks on the face of earth, or a bird that flies in the sky, except they are a nation like you. In a couple of other hadith, the Prophet ﷺ tells us about a person who had a cat, and they locked this cat in a locked room, and they did not give the cat food, and they did not allow the cat to go out and forage and get its own food. The Prophet ﷺ tells us this person will enter hellfire because of that action towards the cat, preventing the livelihood from the cat. And he tells us about another person who was walking in the desert and thirsty, and he came upon a well, but he had to climb in the well to get the water. So he did that. He climbed, he got the water, he satisfied his thirst. But then when he came up, he saw that there was a dog just as thirsty as he was, panting for water. And the man climbs back in the well, gets water, and gives it to the dog. And the Prophet ﷺ tells us this man is in Jannah because of that action. So he is encouraging us even to be merciful to the animals. In fact, in another hadith, he was even talking about trees. The Prophet ﷺ says, "Man qata'a sidratan sawwaba Allahu ra'sahu fi an-nar." Whoever cuts a sidra tree, a sidra is a kind of trees in the Arabian Peninsula. So he says, whoever cuts one of those trees, Allah will make him head towards hellfire. The Sahaba understood this meaning. After the Prophet ﷺ passed away, when Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was sending one of the armies and he was giving them his advice, one of his advice is, do not cut trees, as armies do. When they overcome an area, they pillage, they burn, they just ruin things. One of his advice to his army is, do not cut trees when there is no reason for it. And so the mercy of the Prophet ﷺ extended beyond human beings. It even extended to the sinners. In a hadith, a man came to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, "Ya Rasulullah, halaktu wa ahlakt." O Messenger of Allah, I have perished and I have caused someone to perish. So the Prophet ﷺ asked him, "Wama dhak? How is that?" The man said, "I had marital relationships with my wife during the daytime in Ramadan, causing his siyam to be ruined, as we know." And as we know, there are many ahadith that say if you ruin your siyam purposely in Ramadan, it is a major sin. And if you fast the rest of your life, you cannot make it up. But this man is coming to the Prophet ﷺ with repentance and asking for a solution. And at that moment, if this man came to any of us, we would be admonishing him. We would be telling him how grave his sin is. We would be telling him, "I don't know what you can do. There's nothing you can do." And we would be telling him of the hadith that if you fast the rest of your life, you cannot make up that day. But the Prophet ﷺ didn't do any of that. He said to him, "A'tiq raqaba," free a slave to make up for your mistake. The man said, "I am poor, Ya Rasulullah, I can't afford to free a slave." So the Prophet ﷺ said, "Why don't you fast 60 consecutive days?" And the man said, "That's what got me in trouble. I couldn't, you know, bear just the Ramadan, and I got in trouble. I cannot fast 60 consecutive days." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Feed 60 poor people, 60 needy people, The man said, again, I'm poor. I cannot afford it, Ya Rasulullah. And so the Prophet ﷺ looks around and he sees a branch of dates. And so he takes it, he gives it to the man, and he says, تصدق بهذا. Take this and give it in charity. The man says, أعلى أحوج منا يا رسول الله. I don't know any family that's more needy than my family. The Prophet ﷺ says, فأطعمه عيالك. Feed it to your family. Can you imagine someone comes with this major sin that they're confessing to, and instead of punishment and admonishment and even just judging language, none of that. He goes away with a sadaqah for his family. That is the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is what we sorely need when dealing with each other, when dealing with our family members, when dealing with our friends, our community members. We have to approach it with their best interest in our mind. Just a quick note, this hadith is not a license to go commit major sins. In this case, the man could have just not said anything and no one would have known of his sin, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the fact that he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking for a solution, that's a major sign that he is repenting. And that is what the Prophet ﷺ recognized. And instead of shunning him away and shunning his repentance, he gave him the way to complete his repentance. So there's a important difference here. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to practice the character of the Prophet ﷺ and to use him as our example and to aspire to be as him. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, the mercy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam even extended to his enemies. There are many examples again of the seerah, but because of time, I'm just going to mention one of them. During the Battle of Uhud, when the army of Quraysh or some of them got to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they hit him. They injured him. They almost killed him. Some of the Sahaba asked the Prophet ﷺ to make dua against them. And the Prophet ﷺ said, ما أرسلت طعانا ولا لعانا أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. I was not sent to be a cursor or to be someone who invokes the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon people. And instead he said, اللهم اهدي قومي فإنهم لا يعلمون. Oh Allah, give guidance to my people for they don't know not. That is the kind of mercy we're talking about. When we said that وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين, that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was not sent except as a mercy for all creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now that he is no longer with us, it is on you and me to communicate that mercy, to practice that mercy, to put that example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in action. And we need to be the ones who are bearers of that torch. If we want to communicate this message, this religion, to those who are around us, we have to do it not because we think we know something that they don't know or that we are better from them. We have to approach it that we want the best for those who are around us. We care about their well-being. We care about them as the Prophet ﷺ cared about those who are around them. And only with that mindset is when we can be effective in communicating the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the teachings of His Prophet. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to see the truth as truth and follow it, and see falsehood as falsehood and stay away from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran by saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صلِّ وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.